Okay.
Hello.
Let me turn off the fan. Hopefully he doesn't, yeah.
Okay. Bear with us as we get sweaty.
Yes, it will get very warm in here, but we're happy to be back.
It's getting hot in here.
Okay, so I guess you can see some things haven't changed. It's good to be back. Welcome to another video. My name is Kwame, and this is...
Hi, I'm Elaine.
And this is Me Plus You Is Us. We haven't done a video in a long time, and it's because, well, other things have been happening in our lives. The first one being that I was in the funk. That's the
creative
first one.
Creative funk.
I was in the creative funk. I didn't feel like doing so much with YouTube. But I was doing other things on the side. For example, I joined the AU Media Fellowship. I mentioned in my previous video. Mm-hmm. I made a short film, Jolt, which is about a father and son relationship. And in relation to Jolt, something else happened. You guys remember our previous video where we said we're expanding our family,
yes.
Right? And then we showed you Nala, who was the expansion to the family.
Yes.
But what we didn't know was...
Something else was also expanding.
Something else was also expanding. So even though people were, I mean, commenting that, we thought you were pregnant and everything, we actually...
We laughed.
Yeah.
We're like, no way.
No way, we're not pregnant. It's not even close there.
We are starting with the dog.
We're starting
with
the dog.
Furry baby first.
Furry baby first.
Yes.
However, what we didn't know was...
There was more abundance coming our way. More than just a furry friend.
Just a few weeks.
Around the same time.
Yeah.
If we calculate back.
To when we found out that, yes, we are expecting a child. Then it's around the same time Nala came into our lives. Yeah.
I think it's cute how happy you look when you say that.
I just can't stop. I don't know. Yeah. It's I don't know. I'm happy.
Yeah. It's nice.
Yeah, I'm happy.
I'm also happy, but with you it's very visible. It's a good thing.
But in this video, in our coming back, we just wanted to
come back.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
But we just wanted to talk about how we got here, how we got to...
The decision.
The decision to start or start a family this way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I think for me, I love it when people announce their achievements and also when people announce like, oh, we're expecting.
Yeah.
I think it's really nice, but... People often don't talk about why did you decide to want to or be open for a child.
Yeah.
And even with my friends, they said, if I asked that question, they said, like, I didn't get that question a lot. It's like, I'm sure it's also private, but it can also help other people to...
Yeah. Learn or, I mean, think some things through before starting, so...
Because they often portray wanting to start a family as something that is just there. Like, it's just you get to that stage and that's it. But, for example, for me, I mean, yes, I got to the stage, but it wasn't as maybe... as how you think all women want it so badly.
Yeah.
And that's why we are now here.
Yeah. Because between the two of us, I was the one who was ready. I think in some of our videos it did come up at some point. But I've always been the one who's been ready. But my motivation for wanting to have a child was is based on two things. That I mean, the social construct of having your own tribe with the person you love, is there's that. But also... The second reason is that to do it with somebody who you knew in your heart of hearts that it would be easier to work with having such a responsibility.
Yeah.
So if I knew that my partner wasn't ready or the kind of person that I wanted to raise a child with, I don't think my enthusiasm would have been the same as when I like I am with her, and I know that if we do start a family, I know that I'm with somebody who is, you know, on the same wavelength of commitment, on the same wavelength of wanting to do things right with somebody and sharing that responsibility. So that's my motivation.
Yeah. And I think Grandma has always been a bit more ready. Like he was, but that's always been the case in our relationship.
Yeah.
I mean, he proposed, he's always a bit ahead of at least my schedule. But we did have a lot of conversation about it. And I, for me, one of the main things I was not sure of is, I mean, for him, it's easy to decide, right? Like, oh, I want a child because honestly, you're not carrying it. But for me...
That's not why I want a child.
No, but I mean, it's easier for you to take a decision because you're the man. So for me, I literally have to carry the child like inside of me, and you have all these side effects, hormones, your body changes, you're tired all the time. And that one, I wasn't sure if I would be
ready for it.
Ready for it. And also, hormones can be very difficult to deal with. And what if it would change me like a lot? And then what? Like, you still have to function, you have to go to work, you have to do this, you have to do that. So that for me was a bit of a question mark. Like, how do you handle that? So
you needed to reconcile all these questions with yourself.
Yeah, it's good to understand like where what you're getting into. And of course, so for me, I found out that my motivation to have a child is because I want to do it with Kwame, and not because I've always wanted to be a mom. I like kids a lot. I get along with them very well. They bring a lot of joy. But it's not like if I was by myself that I would then go ahead and be single mom just because for the sake of wanting to be a mom. You get what I mean?
Yeah.
So for me, the motivation is in doing this together. And I think honestly, like what starting a family or wanting a child or being open to it is not a logical decision. Because if you look at
the logistics
of the money a child costs, all the things you have to take care of,
and even the biological aspect as well, and all the possibilities of what could go wrong and all that. Yeah,
you can, you know, you can have severe complications.
There are more reasons to not do it than to do it.
Yeah, and also look at the state of the world we are in. I mean, there's a lot of crisis going on. Look at the economy in Ghana. It's not going to be easy adding another person to feed.
And which for me brings me to the aspect of our social interaction with people, that you should not give anybody that, you know, culturally we have that I don't know if it's cultural or social, it's a social thing that, but when somebody, like people want to go through the phases of what life is supposed to be, get married, have kids, have your home and whatnot. So when somebody is not in a relationship, when are you going to get a relationship? When are you going to get married? When you get married, when are you going to have kids? Yeah. So it cements people who are deciding that they don't want to have kids. And it makes you understand that it's okay for somebody to decide that, because ideally, if you look at it in a rational way, more people not wanting to have kids with where the economy is at the moment, mentally being available to do it or not, and financially and everything, please give people space. And
it's a very personal decision. And I think there are more like negatives than positives to it, if you're being really rational. So it's not a logical decision to say yes.
Yeah.
So that's also something we found out, like you can make lists and lists of pro and cons, but in the end, it is your feeling that says like, okay, we want to do this or not.
Yeah.
And
with a partner that you feel safe enough to do it with.
Yeah, that's so also very important.
So it's not a choice that comes just cause. You have to give it a lot of thought. And I'm really grateful that even though my senses or my general senses were like, you know, I'm ready, I want to do this, but I appreciate the fact that on the other side, my partner is thinking much more on the other bits, more so there's a balance of these decisions.
But even like the psychological side of it, like, I mean, I think we are quite mature in, like, we grow together, we communicate, we try, but I mean, we're not perfect people, right?
Yeah.
And you will bring that along in raising a child. So you will make mistakes and you will put some things that you maybe have not processed onto a child. And you have to also be ready for that, that I'm going to mess up.
Yeah.
And then we have to deal with that.
Yeah.
And be open about it. Like, we didn't know any better. And I'm sorry, you know. So that was also a big question for me, like, how do you know that you're ready? And I think at some point I realized that I don't think I'm going to be ever more ready than now, because I think I will always be a mom who is a mom, but also other things, like, I would want to always have
be your person,
have be my own person, yes, outside of being
like a parent.
Just like how I'm your spouse, but I'm also
your person who likes your things you like and do
does the things you do. I'm also a friend, I'm also a sister, I'm a daughter. Like, I like
and you want to exist for all those things that you
yeah, require. And of course, I mean, it will shift when you get a child, I assume, because it's a big part, it's a part of you. But I would still want also to show our future child, like, you can be a lot of things at the same time,
yeah,
and still be a whole person.
Yeah.
So for me, that, like, how sometimes women are portrayed, and I'm sure there are a lot of women who have that super intense urge to be a mom, but for me, I realized that that's not there, but it doesn't mean I don't want it. I want it in my own
and
way.
And does it mean that you are a bad person for not wanting it in the same way that society expects you to want it?
Yeah, like, as badly, and like,
as, yeah.
Whoa, this is, I will not, like, how you say, it's not my, I don't think it will be my holy grail. Yeah. Like, whoa, now I'm finished. Like, I can,
yeah.
My life is done.
I have succeeded.
I can just chill the rest of my life. No, I don't think that that's how it works for me. But I do think I'm excited for what it can bring and what it will add to my life and what's like the exchange of, because people always say, I want to teach my child this, this, and this, but the child will teach you a lot.
Yeah.
And the other way around.
Yeah, and we're learning that from having Nala in our lives as well. So I guess what we are trying to say essentially is, one, it's good to be back. Two, we're expecting a child. And three, this is how we got to deciding
the decision of
wanting to start a family.
And one more thing, I think what we did is we decided, like, we want to try, but I think also people forget that it's not in our hands whether
it works or not,
it will work out or not. So we literally said we want to try, but we're not gonna focus on it, we're just gonna live our lives and see what happens.
Yeah.
And it happened pretty fast. But people also, like, how people ask, like, oh, when are you going to have children? It's like you have certain control.
And you
that's
don't.
Not, you don't have that.
You
like,
don't.
It's up to whatever you believe in, but, like, it's
also
faith.
The biology side of things as well. So,
and
there's so many factors.
Maybe could have taken us much longer, and then you're still happily, like, open to the idea, but it's not
to
up
put
to
that much pressure on yourself.
Yeah. So, I think that's also important to, yes, you can have the wish to want to have a child, but we said we're going to try. That's kind of was our mindset.
Yeah.
Instead of, this is what we want.
Yeah.
Instead, like, we're open to it if it comes to us.
Yeah. So we're going to wrap up our first video back here. In our subsequent videos, we're going to share with you a few stories of how we've been.
But we're not only gonna do pregnancy stories, because that's a bit boring.
I know.
Also do other things with our lives.
Yes, other things with our lives. But there will be, I'm just letting them know, there will be a pregnancy series of conversations.
Yeah.
There will be. other things will happen in our lives, but if you're receiving a lot of pregnancy series stuff, it's what we're going through.
Yeah. Did we agree on the name?
For the baby?
No, of the series.
No, they should help us decide.
I want the baby boom, because for us it came quite sudden.
So should I name this baby boom EP1?
If you want. Why we decided to
start a family.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's it for this video. We'll catch you in the next one, hopefully soon. yes, hopefully soon. I'm serious. Hopefully soon. My name is Kwame and
I'm Elaine.
And this is Me Plus You is
Us.
And we're happy to be back. We'll catch you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.